antonyms and synonyms. Our first chapter for verbal ability. The word which has an exact opposite meaning of another word is called antonym, and the word which has an exactly same meaning of another word is called synonym. Antonym and synonym questions will test your vocabulary skills, and vocabulary skills are not something which can be developed within a day or a small interval of time. Vocabulary skills are something that you have honed from your childhood. How many novels you have read, how many words you have gone through in the dictionary whose meanings you know, how many new words you learn every day. This is something which builds your vocabulary skills. So when you prepare for a verbal ability test, so if your foundation of English is not proper, then it is going to be difficult for you to crack the verbal ability questions. So when we train students on antonyms and synonyms, then we make sure that we take them through on multiple job assessment papers of multiple multinational companies. And after referring to hundreds of such job assessment papers, we have shortlisted 400 frequently asked antonyms and synonyms. You will get the download link of this document in our description below. Refer to all these words and develop your antonyms and synonyms to face any job assessment test. My dear friends, antonyms might have certain rules which you can follow while finding the opposite meaning of any word, like by adding prefix of DIS, like for example, appears becomes disappear, agree becomes disagree, advantage becomes disadvantage, belief becomes disbelief, continue becomes discontinue, honest becomes dishonest, qualified becomes disqualified, and another prefix like IN, where accurate becomes inaccurate, effective becomes ineffective, decent becomes indecent, discreet becomes indiscreet, formal becomes informal, regular becomes irregular, dependent becomes independent, compatible becomes incompatible, complete becomes incomplete, visible becomes invisible. Then the next prefix is IM, like balance becomes imbalance, mature becomes immature, mobile becomes immobile, movable becomes immovable, measurable becomes immeasurable. Or by adding prefix like MIS, where conduct becomes misconduct, behave becomes misbehave, interpret becomes misinterpret, lead becomes mislead, trust becomes mistrust, use becomes misuse. Or by adding prefix like none, where payment becomes non-payment, sense becomes nonsense, fiction becomes non-fiction, living becomes non-living, poisonous becomes non-poisonous, renewable becomes non-renewable, resident becomes non-residence, stop becomes non-stop. Then the next popular prefix is un, where authorized becomes unauthorized, available becomes unavailable, conscious becomes unconscious, foreseen becomes unforeseen, faithful becomes unfaithful, necessary becomes unnecessary. Or by adding prefix like IR, where regular can become irregular, relevant can become irrelevant, replaceable becomes irreplaceable, rational becomes irrational, and responsible becomes irresponsible. So these are some kinds of prefixes that you can use while solving questions on antonyms, or which might be helpful for you while choosing the right option for antonyms. But as far as synonyms are concerned, there is no certain rule. To find out that, the only thing that can help you is your knowledge of vocabulary. Now let's have a quick look and understand the kinds of questions that comes in antonyms and synonyms. Choose the word which conveys the opposite meaning for the word. That means antonyms. Now here the word is officious, and the options are repose, unofficial, indifferent, attached, or none of these. Now the meaning of officious is someone who is interfering or someone who wants to offer his advice. And from the options, the word which has the closest meaning to be its antonym is indifferent, because indifference meaning is showing no concern in attitude or action. So the right option is indifferent. Then let's see another example to choose the word which conveys the closest or similar meaning for the word. Now here the word is sleuth, and the options are investigator, traveler, convict, jury, or none of this. Now, the meaning of sleuth is a detective. So the closest meaning to a detective in the options is a investigator. So here, the right option is investigator. Now, these are the types of questions which come in antonyms and synonyms. Now, again, we remind you to download the PDF with top 400 most asked antonyms and synonyms questions for competitive exams and go through them.